Christian, I'm the free teacher, as you all know. Today I'm here to teach a J3 class, and already on the board is the lessons of today. The topic for today's lesson is l'article défini, which is in English called definite article. I hope you enjoy the lesson today. Thank you. As you all see, on the board we have the topic. I hope I'm talking to J3 students. It's called l'article défini, which is a definite article. You know, in French, articles in French are used for identification of noun. And you all know that noun have masculine, feminine, and somehow plural. So we have plurals and masculine, we have plurals and feminine, and some of the noun begins with vowel sound. So all these things are different variations we are going to see in this lesson. And by the end of this lesson, I'm expecting each and every one of you to be able to identify definite articles whenever you see them, that mean the words whenever you see them in sentences, and at the same time apply them, either by using them to make sentences or identify them in sentences. So in French, we have four aspects of definite articles, which is l'article défini. Numéro un, nous avons le. Repeat after me. Le. 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 That is good. Then, numéro deux, nous avons la. Repeat after me. La. La. Encore. Encore. Très bien. Numéro quatre, nous avons les. Répétez. Les. Les. Encore. Très bien. La dernière, c'est les. Les. Ici, nous avons L seulement. We have only L, only. The first one, as we see, number one, is a masculine word. That is, an article that is used for identifying masculine noun, only. It's used for identifying masculine noun. You don't use it for feminine noun, only masculine noun. And that the examples I've been giving to you below. As we have le livre. Repeat, répétez. Le livre. Le livre, le cahier, le cahier, le cahier. Nous avons aussi le crayon, le crayon. That is pencil in English, le crayon. Nous avons aussi le table, that is board in English, le table. If it is blackboard, le tableau noir. If it is whiteboard, whiteboard, le table blanche, le table. Then we have also le marché. Répétez, le marché, le marché. Nous avons aussi le garçon, that is the boy, le garçon, le garçon. Nous avons aussi le sac, le sac, le sac. Ça c'est pour l'article défini comme nous avons le en masculin. Et ici, on va continuer avec la numéro 2, c'est-à-dire la, la, that is la. We are through with the first one, which is le, and now we are continuing with the second one, which is la. La is a feminine article that is used to identify feminine words in French. You don't use, like I said earlier, you don't use masculine words to identify masculine article to identify feminine article. No, it's not done. As masculine goes with masculine noun, and feminine article goes with feminine noun, and you have to know that the singular, these are singulars. These are singular articles, like lo and la are singular articles. Then we're going to see the plural article, which when we come to number three. But for now, we are still in number two. The singular article la, that is used to identify singular noun, only singular noun. You can see them on the board. Like la chaise is a singular word, the chair, la tasse, the car, the glass car, la chemise, the shirt, la classe. The class, la fille, the girl, la table, the table. You can see la table is different from le tableau. You see le tableau here, the board. This one is la table, the table. So table and board are not of the same gender, right? Then we have also la montre. And finally, la vertu. There are so many of them. Time will not permit us to go into all of them. So these are just a pigment of the feminine words that we have. Then we go to number three. Number three is so special in the sense that it combines all the masculine and feminine words together. That is to say, when they are in plural forms. For instance, lay is the form, is the plural form of lo and la. Lo and la are singular, used to identify singular noun only. But lay is used to identify plural nouns. Plural nouns. Whether they are beginning with vowel sound or they are beginning with what? Consonants. Whether beginning with vowel or what? Consonant. And that is why I've been able to bring down some examples we have here and the ones we have here to make up the examples we have of the words we are going to look at under lay. Like you have le cahier here. The plural form of le cahier is le cahier. Le cahier, le cahier. The book, the books. La chaise, les chaises. The chair, the chairs. La tasse, les tasses. The cap, the caps. Le garçon, les garçons. The boy, the boys. La table, les tables. The table, the tables. All right. I hope you enjoyed my lessons today. The final.